Hello, I'm Sri from CBTU. CBTU presents a course on Amazon Web Services, section Amazon EC2 Auto Scaling. With Amazon EC2 Auto Scaling, you can add or remove compute capacity to make changes in demand. Amazon EC2 Auto Scaling helps you maintain application availability, allows you to dynamically scale your Amazon EC2 capacity up or down automatically according to the conditions you define. You can maintain the desired number of Amazon EC2 instances to maintain the health and availability of your fleet. You can scale up during the demand spikes to maintain performance and decrease capacity during lean period to reduce cost. The benefits include improved fault tolerance, increased application availability, and lower costs. Amazon EC2 auto scaling is enabled by Amazon CloudWatch and carries no additional fees. However, Amazon EC2 and Amazon CloudWatch service fees apply and are billed separately. Let us take a demo. Create an AWS account and sign into management console. Then create and configure Amazon EC2 auto scaling group, configure auto scaling policies, and finally clean up when no longer required. These are the features which you have seen. This is Amazon management console. We can select AWS Auto Scaling under Management Tools, or you can search for it. You can also use Amazon EC2 Dashboard. EC2 is under Compute. Let us select this. This is Amazon EC2 Dashboard. On the left navigation menu, you click on Launch Configurations under Auto Scaling. Okay, click on Create Launch Configuration. This is a 6-step process. And the first step is choose AMI. An AMI is a template that contains the software configuration required to launch your instance. You can select the AMIs provided by AWS. You can use your own AMIs, buy from AWS Marketplace, or pick from community AMIs. Let us select Amazon Linux 2 AMI, which is free tier eligible. Step 2, choose instance type. Choose general purpose T2.micro, which is free tier eligible, which has one virtual CPU and 1 GB RAM. Network performance low to moderate. Click next. Step 3, configure details. Let us give a name. You can request for the spot instances now or later, and you can specify the maximum price. Let us go with default unchecked. IAM role. Let it be default none. Monitoring. If you enable CloudWatch detailed monitoring, it is chargeable. Amazon CloudWatch gives complete visibility of your cloud resources and applications. This is chargeable. With Amazon CloudWatch, there is no upfront commitment or minimum fee. You simply pay for what you use. Basic monitoring comes with free tier. You can go to the paid tier as per the business needs. Let us go with default unchecked. Configure advanced details. RAM disk ID. Go with the default. User data. Any startup scripts you want to run. The default option is public IP is assigned to the instances launched in the default VPC. Other options like you can have public IP address to every instance or do not assign any instance. Let us go with default. Click next. Step 4, add storage. Let us go with the default selection. Click next. A security group is a set of firewall rules that control the traffic for your instance. We can create a new group or use an existing security group. Let us create a new security group. This rule is fine for us. TCP, port 22, SSH, access from anywhere is fine for now. Let us click review. It's warning us that security group is open and insecure. It's okay for now. So these are the options which are selected. Let us create launch configuration. For accessing the AWS instances, we need a key pair. You can choose from the existing key pair or create a new key pair. Select existing key pair, acknowledge, create launch configuration. Now, next step is create an auto scaling group using this launch configuration. This is a five-step process. We are in step one, configure auto-scaling group details. Let us give a name. Group size are the desired capacities, the number of instances this group must have at any time. Let us go with two instances. VPC is Amazon Virtual Private Cloud. We can use the existing VPC or create a new one. We can go with existing one. Let us use this. For the subnet, you can use the existing subnets or create a new subnet. Let us go with existing subnets. And each instance in this auto-scaling group will be assigned a public IP address. Advanced details. We can attach load balancer to this auto-scaling group. Health check grace period is the time it will wait to check the health status. Default 300 seconds. Detail monitoring is not enabled for this. It's okay. This is to protect instances from termination. And default service linked IAM role. Let us go with defaults. Click next to configure scaling policies. This is optional and we'll go with the default option. Keep this group at its initial size. Click next. You can configure auto scaling group to send notifications like launching of an instance, termination of an instance, fail to launch or fail to terminate. You can create a new topic, the email address where you want to receive these alerts. These notifications can be sent to only confirmed email addresses. Let us go with default. Let us go to the next step. Configure tags. Tag is a key value pair that can be used to identify this group. Leave it blank for now. Click review. These are the features that we have configured. No scaling policies, notifications no, tags no. Group size is 2, minimum size, maximum size 2. Let us create auto-scaling group. Auto-scaling group is successfully created. Let us view our auto-scaling groups. This is launch configuration that we have created. This is the auto-scaling group that is created. Let us see activity history. So two EC2 instances are created. These instances are created as per the desired capacity that we have set. Okay, let us see the instances. So we have two instances. The two instances are up and running. Let us name them. Let us go back to auto-scaling. The actions that can be taken on this group are edit and delete. This is activity history that we have seen that two instances are successfully created. Scaling policies, we don't have one. Instances. The same thing what we have seen from the Amazon EC2 dashboard. Lifecycle status is both are in service. The other lifecycle states are pending, terminated, or terminating, detaching, standby, or entering standby. This is launch configuration name, availability zone, and health status. Protection from scaling we have not opted. Let us test auto scaling how it works. So we got desired capacity of 2. We can select any instance and we can click on detach. Detach will remove the instance from auto scaling group and from any associated load balancers. And this will replace the instance with new running instance to meet the desired capacity. It will replace only when you check this. Add a new instance to the auto scaling group. If you don't check this, the desired capacity will be reduced by 1. Let us delete the instance from EC2 dashboard. We have 2 running instances. Let us delete 1 and see what happens in auto scaling. Terminate. Click yes. Let us go to auto scaling groups. The default cooldown for the auto scaling group is 300 seconds, that is 5 minutes. So it takes about 5 minutes until you see the scaling activity. Let us pause and come back to this. This is monitoring. notifications, tags, schedule actions. We can schedule an action to meet the dynamic capacity by configuring minimum and maximum and desired capacity and recurrence status and when to start. You can create one. You can create lifestyle hooks. This is to perform custom actions like instance launch or instance terminate. Action abandon or continue. Let us check the instances still in service. Go back to EC2 dashboard. See, instance 2 is terminated. Auto scaling has provisioned another instance that is running. And let us check activity history. So terminating this instance is terminated and auto scaling group launched another instance to meet the desired configured capacity. When you have more number of instances, you can check status, which are successful, in progress, and others. You can copy this launch configuration to a launch template, and you can use the launch templates to create instances. Amazon EC2 dashboard launch, you have the option to launch from the template. As a final step, you don't want this auto scaling group or the instances. You need to remove the auto scaling group first. Let us do the cleanup. Delete auto scaling group. It will take a couple of minutes. Auto scaling pricing. Launch instance. Launch configurations and auto scaling groups. Create launch configuration in 6 steps. Auto scaling group is deleted. Let us delete launch configuration as well. Deleted. And let us go to EC2 dashboard. Deleting auto scaling group also deleted the instances. So these instances are terminated. Thanks for watching.